Now, let's introduce the second metric. The first one was the average value, and now we're looking at the average reward, or average one-step reward. What is it? It's expressed as this. We can see that here, instead of V pi s, we now have R pi s. R pi s represents the average immediate reward I can get when starting from state s. Its expression will be given shortly. D pi s is the weight for state s. From the subscript, we can tell it is the stationary distribution which depends on the policy pi. Then, we take the weighted average of R pi s to obtain this metric, which we call R pi bar. The bar on top of R pi indicates that this is an average. Since d pi s is a probability distribution, we can write this sum as an expectation form. Now, what exactly is r pi s? The equation for r pi s is as follows. It represents the average immediate reward I can get when in state s. Specifically, I have many possible actions to choose from in state s. If I choose action A, the probability of selecting action A is this. After choosing action A, the reward I get is this. Then, summing this up gives r pi s. So, RSA represents the average immediate reward I can get after taking action A in state S. This can also be written in the following form. If I take action A in state S, the immediate reward I get is RSA. Then, I take the weighted average or expectation over all possible actions to obtain R pi S, which is the average immediate reward for state S. Finally, by taking the expectation or weighted average over all states S, we get r pi bar, which is the second metric. Here, d pi represents the stationary distribution. Now, let me present another important equivalent expression of this metric. When you read papers and books, you'll often come across this expression. Let's take a look at it. Suppose an agent follows a given policy and generates a trajectory. Along this trajectory, I receive many rewards. RT plus 1, RT plus 2, and so on. What do I do next? I sum up all of these rewards. Let's assume I start from state S0. After summing, I take the expectation, since these are random variables, and then I divide by n to calculate the average. Finally, I take the limit as n approaches infinity. This expression can be simplified to this form. What does this represent? It represents the average of the rewards after running for an infinite number of steps. This can be further rewritten in the following form. As you can see, I started from S0 earlier, but now S0 is gone. Why? Because after running for an infinite number of steps, the initial starting state no longer matters. We arrive at the following expression, which you can often see in papers. When you see this expression, I hope you'll understand clearly as I've explained it in detail in my course. What is this expression? It's r pi bar, which can be written as d pi s r pi s and then take the weighted average. This is exactly the second metric we introduced just now, r pi bar. Why is that? The specific details can't be expanded further here, but you can refer to my book for detailed proof. The proof involves some math, but it's not that complicated. In short, when you come across this metric in the future, remember that we've already discussed it in this course. We've just introduced two metrics. Next, let's see some more remarks and an example afterward. The first remark is that these metrics are all functions of the policy. Whether it's V pi bar or R pi bar, both are functions of the policy, and this policy is parameterized by theta. Therefore, both V pi bar and R pi bar are functions of theta. Different values of theta will give different values of the metric. Our goal is to optimize and find an optimal theta that maximizes the metrics. This is the basic idea of policy gradient methods. The second remark is that, if you carefully examine the metrics, it's still a bit tricky. Why? Because we need to distinguish the discounted case and the undiscounted case. In the discounted case, there's a discount rate gamma, which is less than 1. In the undiscounted case, gamma equals 1. So far, we've only introduced the discounted case in the entire course. Why does the undiscounted case appear? Because the r pi bar metric merely involves immediate rewards, we don't need to consider the discount rate. Therefore, both the discounted and undiscounted cases are valid for this metric. However, the undiscounted case is more complex, so we won't dive into it here. If you're interested, feel free to check out the detailed explanation in my book. The third remark is about the relationship between rpy bar and vpy bar. What's the relationship between them? Intuitively, rpy bar seems more short-sighted compared to vpy bar. Why? Because rpy bar seems to focus solely on the immediate rewards, while vpy bar is about the return. That is, the total accumulated rewards over many steps. But is that really the case? In fact, it may be surprising that these two metrics are equivalent to each other. In the discounted case, we can prove that rpy bar equals 1 minus gamma times vpy bar. Note that when I say equivalent, I don't mean that they are exactly the same. Rather, I mean that they satisfy this equation, which means that they will be optimized simultaneously. That is, when you optimize one of them, the other will also reach its optimum. For the proof of this equation, you can refer to my book. Now, let's move on to an example. If this course is taught offline, I would ask the students to take a moment and work on it. For those of you watching online, feel free to give it a try as well. Here's the exercise. When you're reading papers or other references on policy gradient, you often come across this metric. Does it relate to the metrics we've just discussed? Let me give you the answer directly, though you can think about it if you prefer. Earlier, we mentioned that rpy bar has two definitions. One is rpy bar equals sum over sdpy s rpy s. The other is rpy bar equals limit as n approaches infinity 1 over n times expectation of sum from t equals 1 to n of rt. Similarly, vpy bar also has two definitions. One is vpy bar equals sum over sds vpy s. The other is this equation. If you read policy gradient or actor critic papers, you're very likely to encounter one of these two equations. Whether this one or this one, I hope you can recognize them immediately because we've covered them in this course. The fact is that this is actually vpy bar. Why is that? Let's take a look. In fact, it is very simple. You might be confused at first, but it's actually straightforward. Let's assume this trajectory starts from state S0 and S0 obeys this distribution. Then I get a trajectory. S0, A0, R1, S1, A1, and so on. In each state S, how do I choose the action? I choose the action based on the policy pi S. After taking the action, the resulting reward, RT plus 1, and next state, ST plus 1, are determined by the environment. Now we can break down the equation further. First, according to the basic property of total expectation, we can write it in this form. This is because we can start from different states S. If we start from state S, the probability of starting from S is dS. And the value for this state is given by this expression. Adding these values together gives us the following equation. So, what is this expression? Can you recognize it? This is actually the total discounted return obtained starting from state S. Because it's essentially the discounted return, this equals GT, and this in turn equals V pi S. Therefore, the whole equation simplifies to sigma d pi s v pi s, which equals v pi bar. As I mentioned, it is actually quite straightforward.